Hi guys, welcome to PG All in One. In today's video, we will learn how a common man with small business can get his GST IN, that is GST number, with some simple step. Nowadays, we all know that nobody is ready to do business with you if you don't have a GST IN number. People like real estate agent, broker, consultant, or other service provider, all type of agent, and those who work for online, from online, or for online business who don't have a registration place of business can also get their own GST IN number by registering a GST website. And trust me, after watching this full video, you will not feel that you need a CA, that is chartered accountant, for registering your GST number. GST registration process is online and there is no manual form to apply for GST IN. Three important things to remember for GST registration process. First one is time required to get GST IN, that is GST number. Second thing is document required, and last one is procedure to apply for GST IN. First thing, time required to get a GST IN number is minimum 10 days. Second thing is the required document, that are PAN, proof of place of business, and bank statement where you receive your business income. Aadhaar card is optional, but if you enter your Aadhaar number, then you can submit your GST application through Aadhaar OTP, one-time password. But remember, without PAN, you can't start it. If you don't know, not have any PAN number, you can click on link provided by me to apply for a PAN online on NSDL website, or another link where you can download PAN form and submit it manually in your state. You should have your photo scan, that is 100 KB, proof of business scan, and bank statement of passbook first page scan 100 KB. No need to scan your PAN card or an Aadhaar card. Proof of place of business can be your electricity bill, municipal tax paid receipt, rent agreement. For this, the size should be below 2 KB of scan copy. If you work online and if you don't have a registered place for your business, then you can attach your own electricity bill, but make sure your address of place of business and address of electricity bill should be not different from each other. In case you have a place of business and it is your own, then attach electricity bill of that place. But if it is not your own, then please make a rent agreement. Please note, having appropriate and correct document for GST registration can save your form from any future risk. Now the third thing is procedure. Let us know in short first. Detailed procedure is explained in this video itself. So first, you need to visit the GST website and register your PAN. Then based on your PAN, you will be provided with TRN. With this TRN, you can log in and fill the form and submit it. This TRN will valid for 19 days only. So you need to submit it with 19 days, then your submitted form will go for processing, and after your processing, you will get ARN number and your detail, login detail will be emailed to you. You have to log in and download your registration certificate within this. Your registration process will get over. Now let's start the process of registration with details. You first need to visit www.gst.go.in or click on below link which is provided in description. Go to service, click on new registration, select your state and district and enter your name as per PAN and enter your PAN number. Now enter your phone number which you use mostly and it is always active. Enter email ID which you use regularly. Now enter code shown in image below and click on proceed button. Your TRN will be generated. Now we have to log in using this TRN. Go to service. Now registration. Now select on new registration and select TRN. One OTP will be get generated and it will be sent to your mobile and email ID. Both OTP will be same. If you don't get message, then you can use your email ID OTP until you get your GST number, that is your user ID and your password. You have to use this TRN as your login detail. Now enter OTP and click on proceed. You will be taken to GST application form. Enter your trade name or business name and your name will be auto filled on first page. Now enter your business or trade name. If you don't have trade name, then enter your name. Select business type. I have selected proprietor as it's my own business. Then you have to select your state code. Then select division code or and range code. Division code and range code are available on service tech site of each state. You can search it on Google. Now you have to ask to enter detail of registration previously held by you. I'm leaving it blank as I don't have any registration. Click on save and continue. Now you have to enter proprietor detail, that is your contact address and photo and all things as per your PAN card. You can put your current address if your PAN address is different from your current address. Enter your proper contact detail. Enter your Aadhaar number. Tick on declaration by UDI and upload your color photo. Click on save and continue. If you want to be authorized as signatory, click on the last button on the same page. Turn it yes and all the detail will be autofilled in authorized signatory sheet. If you want to make someone else as authorized signator to enter GST related work on your behalf, then enter his detail in authorized signatory. And for this, you are required to upload authorized signatory letter. You can mark any one from your authorized signatory as a primary as authorized signatory. The draft of this letter is provided in below link. You can find it in description, in video description. Once this is done, click on save and continue. You will be taken to authorized representative page. I am leaving it blank. You can add authorized representative if you have or leave it blank like me. Click on save and continue. Now the most important page, detail of principal place of business. Please be extra careful while providing this information. Enter proper address and contact detail. Attach proof of constitution of business and select nature of business. Now verify everything and click on save and continue. If you have additional place of business, then that is if you have another branch from where you work, then you can enter this in next sheet. If you don't have any, leave it blank and click on save and continue. Then you have will be asked to select code for your goods and service. This code is called SCN and code for goods and services and SCA for services. This code are available on Google. You can enter this code on search box provided there. when you start entering, option will be available and you need to select appropriate code. Once you are done with this selection of code, click on save and continue. You will be taken to next page, that is bank statement. You need to enter the total number of account maintained by you for the business and click on add. You will get row to enter your bank account. Enter your bank account, enter your bank's IFSC code and click on get address. Your bank address will be autofilled. Now attach your statement or password passbook front page. After successfully uploading, click on save and continue. Last page will be any tax paid. I am leaving it this blank as I have not paid any tax. Click on save and continue. Last page is verification. Before submitting your form, check percentage of your form. If your form is complete, then it will show 100%. If not, then less than 100%. In verification page, you have to tick the box select the authorized signatory to sign your form and enter date and place. Now important thing, there will be three options to submit your form. One is DSC. DSC is digital signature, which have to create by visiting DSC making center nearby you. DSC is always available in pen drive like token. Second thing is Aadhaar OTP. Aadhaar card number will be entered in our form, but if your mobile number is not updated with your Aadhaar detail, then you will not get Aadhaar OTP on your mobile. And the last option is submit by EVC. EVC is electronic verification. When you click on the option, OTP will be sent, and last option is submit by EVC. So when you click on the OTP option, will be OTP will be sent to your email address and register phone. This OTP will be combined of number and alphabet. For example, 1A23B4. You need to enter this and submit your form. You will get message that your form is successfully submitted. If your form is complete without any error, then after 3 days you will get ARN, that is application reference number. After 4-5 days you will get email ID with your GST login detail and password. You just need to log in with your user ID and password and download your registration certificate. In registration certificate, you will get your GSTIN number. Hope this will help you in registering your GST number. Thank you guys for watching. Please hit like button and subscribe, PG All in One. Thank you guys.